Yes, so in previous lecture we discussed about the different characteristics of wastewater. In that we discussed about some physical characteristics of wastewater like color, odor, test, temperature, turbidity of water. Next we discussed about the chemical characteristics of water. In chemical characteristics we discussed about the pH of water, then alkalinity of water, then dissolved oxygen of water, then BOD of water, biochemical oxygen demand, then COD, chemical oxygen demand, then chloride. Okay, so these are the different chemical characteristics of wastewater. After that, we discuss about the biological characteristics of water, that is bacteria, viruses. Okay, so MPN test, which is used to find out the count of bacteria. So these are the various physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of wastewater. Okay. So one of the term we discussed that is the system of sanitation. So system of sanitation, it is a system which is used for its collection, convenience and disposal of the wastewater or type wastewater, whatever the waste. Okay, so this system of sanitation, it is basically two types of system. It is conservancy system and water carriage system. We already discussed what is the difference between conservancy system and water carriage system. Okay, so if you consider hygienic aspect, so water carriage system, it is a very hygienic, and if you consider the conservancy system, the system is very unhygienic. Okay, second thing, if you consider the foul smell, so water carriage system having no foul smell has no chances of putrefaction. If you consider the conservancy system, there is a lot of foul smell due to the putrefaction. Okay, so this is the difference between the water carriage system and conservancy system. Okay, if you consider the pollutional aspect point, so pollutional aspect, in case of pollution, the water carriage system are rare as liquid waste, that is pollutional problems are rare as the liquid waste are directly conveyed through the sewer. Okay, but if you consider the water carriage system, conservancy system, so conservancy system, that creates more pollutional problems because the directly disposal of waste on the land or on the ground, that is what the contamination of the soil. Okay, so this is if you consider the pollutional aspect, so the water carriage sewage system, that is the pollutional problems are rare, and if you consider the conservancy system, the more pollutional problem, and that leads to contamination of soil. We consider the labor aspect, the water carriage sewage system, it is labor requires are negligible or small for the operation and maintenance. But if you consider the conservancy system, this system is depends upon the labors. Okay. Next point, if you consider the final disposal, then water carriage sewage system, the final disposal is easier because of the treatment of waste. And if you consider the conservancy system, the possibility of risk due to the final disposal because it is open disposal and land disposal. Okay, next point, if we consider the land disposal requirement, in case of land disposal required, so if you consider the water carriage sewage system, the land required for the disposal of treated sludge is less, and if you consider the conservancy system, the land required for the disposal of untreated sewage is large because here is whatever the untreated sewage, just collection and dispose of the land. So it requires more land for the disposal. And in case of the sewage system, the land required for the disposal is less because we already treat that sewage into the treatment plant, and after that, that treated sludge is going to be disposed of the land. Okay. If you consider cost, so initial cost is high, but running cost is very less as labor requirement less in case of the water carriage sewage system. And if you consider the cost in conservancy system, so initial cost is small, but the running cost is high as labor requirement is more as compared to the water carriage sewage system. Okay, so these are the some various points that can be can differ the water carriage sewage system and conservancy system. Okay, so now this water carriage system or water carriage sewage system, it is again classify into two types. The first type is the separate system and second one is a combined system. Okay, as the name indicate, separate and combined, we already discussed the separate system and combined system, or separate sewer and combined sewer. So separate system, When the drainage, like a stormwater and sewage, are taken independently of each other through the two different set of conduit, that is called a separate system. Okay, that means when we are going to use two different sewer, one sewer for the collection of sewage and one sewer for the collection of drainage, that is stormwater. Okay, that means two set of sewer. Okay, two different set of sewer, that is called a separate sewer, and that system is called a separate sewage system. And second system, it is a combined system. So when the drainage is taken along with the sewage, it is called as combined system. Okay, that is called as combined sewer. So combined sewer, it is a single sewer, it is a single set of sewer which is used to carry out both drainage, that is stormwater, as well as sewage combinedly. And separate sewer, it is a two set of sewer, two different set of sewer. So one set which is used for the storm drainage, that is stormwater, and second set is for the sewage. So as name indicate, it is combined and it is a separate sewer, or combined system and separate system. Okay, so now from that figure you can identify what is the combined sewer and separate sewer. Okay, so that building, and you can see below the two blue pipe connection. So one pipe which is used for the collection of sewage, and one pipe is used for the collection of stormwater. Okay, so at the end, this both sewage and stormwater, which is collected in a single sewer system. Okay, so that is combined system. And in other figure, that is separate sewer, you can see that is the collection of sewage from a single sewer, that is transported separately, and collection of stormwater is separately, when which is disposed at the disposal point. Okay, so in the figure you can easily understand the combined sewer, which used for the collection of sewage as well as stormwater combinedly, and separate sewer which is used for the collection of sewage separately and the stormwater separately. Okay, so now what is the difference between the separate system and combined system? Okay, so the first thing, the quantity of sewage to be treated is very less in case of separate system. Okay, so the quantity of sewage to be treated is less because the no treatment of stormwater is done. Okay, separate system madhe apan one system it is for the sewage and one system for the stormwater. Okay, so the quantity of sewage to be treated is less as the no treatment of stormwater is done. In case of combined system, as the treatment of both are done, the treatment is costly. Okay, so combined system, it is used for the collection of both sewage and stormwater combinedly. So that means the treatment that going to be costly. Okay, so treatment is costly in case of combined system, and here is treatment is less costly in case of separate system. Second thing, in the cities of more rainfall, this system is more suitable. So separate system is more suitable when the more rainfall. Okay, and combined system, it is in the cities of less rainfall, this system is suitable. Okay, so where is the less rainfall? The combined system is suitable. Next point, as a two set of sewer lines are laid, this system is cheaper because sewage is carried in underground sewer and storm. Okay, so separate system, it is a cheaper. Okay, and if you consider the combined system, overall construction cost is higher than a separate system. Okay, so this separate system, it is a less costly construction cost, and combined system, it is overall construction cost is too much higher. Okay, next point, in narrow street it is difficult to use this system, separate system, it is difficult to use in narrow street, while if you consider the combined system, it is more suitable in narrow street. Okay, next, if you point consider the less degree of sanitation is achieved in this system, as stormwater is disposed without any treatment in case of separate system, and if you consider the combined system, high degree of sanitation is achieved in this system. Okay, so these are the some of points that I differentiate between the separate system and combined system. Okay, so if you consider the point cost, so maintenance cost is in case of separate system, the maintenance cost is costly because of why? Because this separate system, it is a two set of system. So as it is a two set of system, the maintenance cost is going to be higher in case of separate system. If you consider the combined system, so combined system, it is a single set of sewer, one set of sewer, so the maintenance cost is less. Second, construction cost, if you consider the construction cost for separate system, so construction cost is less as the diameter of separate system is less. Okay, if you consider the construction cost for combined system, So construction cost is very high because the large dimension of sewers to be constructed at sufficient depth to receive the sewage. Okay, that's why in case of combined system, the construction cost is high. In case of separate system, construction cost is less. But maintenance cost is less in case of combined system, and maintenance cost is more in case of separate system. Next, choking problems. If you consider choking problems, so due to smaller size of sewer, they are likely to get the chock in case of separate system. So separate system are these smaller diameter sewers, and so that there is more problems with the choking. And if you consider the combined system, due to the larger size of sewer, there are very less chances of the choking, okay, or rare problems of the choking. Next, ventilation. If you consider the ventilation, in case of separate system, as the size of sewer is small, they can be ventilated easily. But if you consider combined system, as the size of sewer is large, they are more difficult to be ventilated. Okay, so this is the difference between the separate system and combined system. Okay, next point, if you consider foul smell, so in case of separate system, foul smell may be there because of the lesser air contact in small size of sewer. Okay, and in case of combined system, due to more air in their larger sewer, the sewer gas that may be formed gets diluted. Okay, so is as a combined system, it is a larger size sewer and larger diameter, so whatever the gases we generated through the sewage, that diluted into the air which is present into the sewer. So there is a rare chances of the foul smell in case of combined system. In opposite, if you consider the separate system, there is very lesser air contact in smaller size sewer. So there is a chances of foul smell. Okay. Next, stormwater pollution. So if you consider separate system, so there is no question of pollution of stormwater, because here is the sewage transported separately and stormwater transported separately. But if you consider the combined system, in case of combined system, the stormwater is unnecessarily polluted as it is mixed with the sewage. Okay, because in combined system, we are going to mix the sewage and the stormwater combining. That's why stormwater is unnecessarily polluted as it mixed with the sewage. Okay. Next, if you consider the load of influent on treatment units, so that part we already discussed. So next point, that is the financial aspect. Okay, so if you consider the financial aspect, the separate system, it is used when the sufficient funds are not available at the beginning. Okay, so when the sufficient funds are not available at the beginning of the system, in case we can use the separate system. But if the sufficient funds are available, in case we can use the combined system. Okay. Next, subsoil condition. If you consider the subsoil condition, in case of separate system, if the subsoil is hard, this system is economical as compared to the larger size of combined system. Okay. Because the separate system, it is a smaller size of sewer and they required less excavation. Okay. And if you consider the combined system, it is a larger size of sewer, so they required more excavation. Okay. Or the harder strata. Okay, so it means if you consider the soil subsoil condition, so when the subsoil condition is hard, the separate system, it is economical, and if you consider combined system, the subsoil is hard, the combined system is not economical. Okay. Next, if you consider space consideration, when the space available for the laying of sewer is restricted, so this system will not be preferred. Which system? Separate system. Okay, that means space is limited in case the separate system is not used, and when there is space availability leaving the sewer is restricted in case combined systems are used. Okay, so these are the different points that can be used for the differentiation of separate sewer and combined sewer, separate system and combined system. Okay, so cost consideration, then choking problems, then ventilation, then foul smell, then financial aspect, then subsoil condition, space consideration, degree of sanitation. Okay, so if you consider the degree of sanitation, separate system, it is a less degree of sanitation is achieved in this system, and if you consider combined system, here is a high degree of sanitation is achieved in this system. Okay, so these are the various points which is used for the separate system and combined system. It is the difference between the separate and combined system. So now we have covered the first module, that is the analysis of wastewater, sampling of wastewater, objective of wastewater treatment plant, then what are the physical characteristics of wastewater, chemical characteristics of wastewater, biological characteristics of wastewater, different terms that related with the sewage and wastewater, like sewage, sewage, domestic sewage, industrial sewage, sanitary sewage, night soil, sewer, separate sewer, combined sewer, branch sewer, okay, sewerage system, dilution factor, okay. And the water carriage sewage system, that is combined system and separate system. Okay, so in the next lecture we are going to discuss the cell purification of natural steam.